This is Intro to Biology. I'm your professor, Dr. Marshall Kane, PhD. It took me 6,205 hours to get my degree. And I know, because I was only allowed in the library 1 hour per day at the San Vicente Correctional Facility while serving a sentence of 25 to life. Now let's talk about that word, life.
Sorry, new phone. Switching to vibrate. Continue. It's really great.
I stared at a crack in the ground of my cell for years, and one day something grew from it. A single blade of grass.
Vibrates louder than the ringer. Gosh. You know what? Turning it off.
A living thing. Growing from dead stone. Get out!
Oh, it's off. It's off.
Out!
I turned it off. Fine. Okay, fine. I'm leaving.
Don't bother coming back.
Seriously? Hey, dude, Sean Penn called. He says to dial it back. Sean Penn is an actor.
I know who Sean Penn is. I seen Milk. Now get out. I know who Sean Penn is. I saw. What the fuck is that movie? Fast Times. Okay.
You deserve a bigger office.
Biggest office I ever had.
I'm here to apologize, Dr. King, and beg you for a seat in biology.
I tell you what, Insink, you want to learn about life? Give up the phone.
Oh, you're asking me for a bribe?
I can't be bought, man. You feel me? See, prison was my walls, but you put your walls up. You and your phone and your attitude and your Fruit Loops cologne. Your walls put up so tight, man, not even a blade of grass can get through. But even if it did, you wouldn't appreciate it. That's why you can't come back to my class.
What's your problem with me, man? And don't act like it's not about me specifically. Because you've been in... Busted!
So, here's what I'm thinking. I'm a drug dealer, right? And you're a scientist. So, couldn't we get, like, a Breaking Bad type of thing going?
Sorry, Starface. You just lost your seat in my class.
First time those words have actually been true.
Miss Edison, when you called me down here at midnight, I expected more than a yam. Specifically since you said there's been a murder.
Our yam was murdered.
If it was any consolation, she got me here on a very misleading text message.
Jeff, technically you are about to be screwed in the biology room because our final project has been destroyed.
All right, look, I'm sorry for your loss. I know you guys put the work in so you'll get a passing grade.
A passing grade? Like a C? Why didn't I just get pregnant at a bus station? That was going to be an A-plus yam.
I can't give an A-plus to everyone whose yam falls off a counter.
Somebody did this to us.
In science, we call that a hypothesis. You find something to back it up and we can talk. Now, if you'll excuse me, I was watching Mama's Family.
Folks, I have a class in 5 minutes and none of you guys are in it.
After conducting a full investigation, my study group now has definitive proof that Todd, with malice aforethought, smashed our yam.
That's a serious allegation. I hope you can back it up.
We can place him in the building Monday night. He has a mysterious bandage on his hand, and we have an eyewitness who saw Todd drop the jar and flee.
Well, Todd, what do you have to say?
I just wanted...
Don't answer that, soldier. This man is an American hero.
And who are you?
I'm Lieutenant Colonel Archwood, United States Army. I had the pleasure of commanding this young man in Iraq. I'm staying on his couch this weekend while I'm in town for a wedding.
Hold up. I grade my students. Now, what Starface was doing is irrelevant. What matters is what he saw. I'm upholding the pinky swear.
What?
Yo, man, you spent your life in the Army. I spent mine in prison. Two places where a man's word is only as good as his uniform. Now, out here, it's supposed to be different. And in my class, it will be. You two can plead your case to the class and let them decide your grades.
Professor, thank you.
It's not a favor, Mr. Winger. A man's gotta have a code.
Awesome.
See you in class.
Objection, I hate the both of you. You may proceed, Miss Edison, but do so with caution. Need I remind you this is not a courtroom.
All right. After speaking to the wronged parties, I've decided to...
If it pleases the bio class, I have closing arguments.
Of course you do. Holy crap! We are definitely dissecting pine cones next year.
Neil has agreed to retake biology over the summer, and his status as Keymaster has been revoked.
After all the politics and procedure, in the end, the case really was about biology.
Told you it was an important subject. Hello? I understand. Starburns got rear-ended in the meth lab and his trunk exploded. He's dead. Lab assignment is to construct a terrarium. Sort of like a diorama. You guys have weird reactions to stuff. Hey, can I ask you something? This is unrelated. As someone who just finished spending the majority of his life in prison, what happened with Legos? They used to be simple. Now, come on, I know you know what I'm talking about. Legos were simple. Something happened out here while I was inside. Harry Potter Legos, Star Wars Legos, complicated kits, tiny little blocks. I mean, I'm not saying it's bad, I just want to know what happened. All right, fine. Your terrariums are due tomorrow. And everyone, look across the table at the person in front of you. That's your lab partner for the rest of the semester. Saddle up.
Oh, please, Professor Kane?
Yes?
I know you haven't been here at Greendale very long, but, we're a study group.
Mm-hmm. That's kind of a thing. We've been through a lot.
You probably heard of the space bus.
Hey, Paul.
I had sex with Eartha Kitt in an airplane bathroom, and these are the only guys I've ever told her.
Yeah, we're like a family. We love each other.
Second paintball.
What is happening at the school? I have so many conversations that make no sense.
We'd really prefer to partner up amongst ourselves.
Yes. I don't care. Go ahead.
Oh, great.
We will not regret it.
This caterpillar will come out of its cocoon and then...
Pop, pop!
Yeah. Nice work, you two. You know they're laughing at you, right? I mean, that's my theory. Now, super group, I can't help but notice a sorry lack of terrariums.
We didn't have time to finish. Here's mine.
When did you even have time to do that? You're pathological.
It's too late for flattery.
Professor? Obviously, this isn't working out. You're just gonna have to put us with our original lab partners, all right?
I don't have to do anything. Not after you broke my boy, Todd. That man called me crying this morning. You know he fought in Iraq, right? We had a name for people like you in prison. We called you the Mean Clique. But I have a solution. All seven of you will share a microscope, one bench, and one grade that I will average. Everyone else gets their own stuff.
So can we get an extension on the first assignment?
No. You all fail.